Hi everybody and welcome to my channel for my first ever speed build. My name's Silver and for you I have an autumnal family craftsman home. Now the idea was that I would start a channel just because I love to build in The Sims. I've been playing for, since the first Sims, really. And I just thought that it would be a good idea to share what I love to do with everybody and make sure that they can maybe enjoy it too. So I decided to build a craftsman, pretty basic, I suppose. But now that we're getting into the autumn season, I thought it would be a really fun idea to get that autumn feel. So I went with the darker colors and actually in the screenshots, I took them in autumn. So you will be able to see exactly what it looks like with the seasons. It's not a limited pack build, of course, as you can probably already see. I used all of the expansion packs that we currently have, as well as Strangerville, although I have no idea what I used that was from Strangerville, but I'm sure you'll find it, and I guess it wasn't that important if I can't remember what it is. As well as Jungle Adventure, Parenthood, Dine Out, and the stuff packs I used were my first pet stuff, Laundry Day, Toddler Stuff, Backyard Stuff, and Perfect Patio. I'm not sure if I'm going to do the entire voiceover for this video, but I guess we'll see how it goes. If you haven't already noticed, there is a glitch that we have with the columns, and you can easily just get rid of that by drawing a wall, or changing the color, actually. And here I was trying to build a garage. I didn't end up adding a car to it because of the terrain editing is a bit funny. It doesn't snap objects to it, so there was really kind of no point trying. So I also was having a little bit of trouble with the shape of the build. It was just not working for me at first. In the end, I really like it, but I had to move it and all of that editing was for naught, and I really got to remember that I have to get the shape of the build before I start doing any editing to the terrain and or like the coloring of the terrain, which is really important. I don't know if anybody else is getting this glitch either, where like the terrain editing doesn't snap to it either. Like before I could place items, you'll see it later in the video, but before I would be able to edit the terrain with no issues, and then all of a sudden it's now it's like trying to terrain edit under a foundation, if that makes sense. So I imagined this home to be for a smaller family, you know, two parents, two kids, you know, pretty standard family home, and I guess they just really like autumn. I guess you wouldn't. The orange colors are nice. I end up changing the color of the windows and the columns because it just wasn't working. I like the kind of reddish brown, but it didn't really fit, if that makes... I don't know why I keep saying if that makes sense. Of course it makes sense. If I don't like it, I don't like it. It's as simple as. And here I am going into the interior and starting the floor plan. I had a little bit of trouble with it because I wanted a mud room and then I completely forgot to put in a bathroom. And you'll see here in a little bit me fiddling with it, or trying to. And I think this is where I decided that, nope, maybe not. Where I decided I didn't like the color. Oh, I was gonna put the bathroom at the front of the house, but it just, I don't like bathrooms being at the front of the house, especially in front of such a big window. I think it's quite intrusive. And then I thought I could put it in the garage, but then it would be off the kitchen. And I don't know. I know it's realistic that some houses would have that, but I didn't think it was realistic that it would be in the garage. And also that it, you know, is not very hygienic, if that makes sense. Because of course, oh, here I'm going up to the second floor, and I wanted to make sure that there were enough bedrooms for two kids. And I liked the idea of there being an ensuite for the master, but I really couldn't fit it unless I wanted to make, again, the bathroom at the front of the house, and it just wasn't working for me in that viewpoint. But this irritates me so much. Why do the colors not match? I'm trying to find one that works and none of them match. Oh, it's so frustrating. It's just a simple thing that I feel like could be fixed. And normally I actually use custom content, but as I'm starting a YouTube channel, I feel like it would be more fair to people if my videos were available to everyone. And honestly, I was surprised. I was surprised I liked it because I'm so used to using custom content. I've always used it that, you know, it was a surprise that I liked it because custom content adds such a rich diversity to your game, I suppose. But I was very pleasantly surprised because I still found that diversity just within the game itself. Although I have realized that I'm definitely going to be needing to get some of the packs that I had previously foregone because I was using custom content. Simple things like, you know, I can't even name one off the top of my head, but movie stuff pack would be cool. Like, I don't have any boho items in the game. Here, I was fiddling with the colors, and I think, like I said before, I thought this was, I change the color scheme because it just really wasn't working for me. I really wanted this like dark chocolatey brown, or I guess it's not really dark, but like this nice chocolatey brown, but it came with a different color of the stone, so I decided to change the whole thing and make it match, and ultimately I think this is what I kept, and yeah, I think it works. You know, it's different to what I normally do, but I very much enjoyed it. I like the rich, dark colors, and I think it really works in the autumn season especially. And here I am just adding the, what are those called? The little roof things, I can't remember what they're called now. some brick to maybe lighten it up a little bit and make it more, intricate. Some of my roof pieces got deleted here, and I'm not entirely sure why, but this, you know, I'm just replacing it now, and trying to find a color to make the garage door a bit more usable, like, and here I am again fiddling with the bathroom because I just wasn't happy with it, and ultimately I did do this. I kept this shape, and it made the kitchen look a lot better, in my opinion, and, yeah. I think the only thing I'm missing in terms of CC, really, is the fact that, like, I noticed how little clutter we actually have in the game, that's diverse, and also wall colorings and floorings. Like, I didn't mind these, walls, per se. Like, that's not the issue, but, like, I don't know, maybe you'll see it in my video tomorrow where I will be uploading a suburban build and that's more crisp. And I think the walls in The Sims aren't as crisp as maybe I'd like. I don't know how I can describe that any differently than crisp. so we'll see, but the kitchen's coming along. I pretty much kept this layout, except I will add an island, as you'll see in a minute. I don't normally keep the fridge separate from the rest of the, normally I keep it with the counters, but I think here it had a really perfect spot, and, you know, it worked, and here I am fiddling with the counters, because it bothers me that it doesn't snap to the edge, and there's like that little space that nobody's ever going to be able to clean. You know, good for them, I guess. And these don't snap either, so I had to move it over. And so this is a toddler friendly house, so I added a microwave to make sure you can get your chicken nuggets, because let's be real here, that's the most important part of the build, chicken nuggets. And adding some clutter. There's not much more I can say for the kitchen, really. I guess, you know, I was really pleasantly surprised, and I'm kind of looking forward to going in the future, no CC, because it really kind of opened up what's in the game for me when maybe before I didn't realize that it was even there. You know, like I never would have used those before, really, because, you know, CC. But if you are a CC user, that's, you know, again, totally fine, of course, like you do you, but I'm kind of glad that it's out of my game. And in here, I'm putting the laundry room. Yes, this build does have laundry. I'm sorry to those who do not like laundry, but I personally think it makes sense, especially in a family home. And I liked it. And I figured the garage was the best place for it, to be honest. So as I said, I imagine like a family living here, and I think I added a dog bowl in the, well, a cat bowl, because I assumed it would be a cat living here. I think we also, there is a litter box, and I do add toys and, you know, everything your cat really could need. But I imagined it was a toddler who loved animals, and their mom got them like an orange tabby cat or something, and you'll see it here how much the kid loves pets and animals, particularly cats. I know when I was a kid I really wanted a cat, and I'm really glad that I have them now. So I definitely was a little inspired by what I as a child would have liked my room to be, I suppose. So here I'm adding some fall decor. A lot of seasons was used here, and I just flat out used the seasons, the fall seasonal curtains. And I think it's subtle enough that you could use this house normally, and of course you could just change the color if you wanted to use this house not for autumn and delete, you know, some of the autumn decorations. I think it's very usable, regardless to being a autumnal house. But again, I was just really inspired by fall, and it's getting kind of cold outside, so, you know, I thought it would be a nice change from all the summery builds after getting Island Living, and yeah, I just thought it would be nice. And yeah. Well, here I'm adding the cat scratcher, which, you know, important. I was going to add a toy box down here because it is a family home, but it just didn't really mesh well for me. I didn't really care for it, but I did add a cat toy and you know, some plants, more sunflowers, because sunflowers for some reason scream like fall to me. I am not entirely sure why, because I know they can, that they're picked in the summer. I don't know if they're picked in the fall too. I just don't know, but yeah, it just seemed to fit for me, so I, you know, went ahead and added those. And I'm trying to find a rug. It was a struggle, okay? It was a struggle. So I went with this one from Laundry Day, and I think it works. It's just a plain brown rug. It does what it needs to, and I added a, here I found some fall stuff, like pumpkins. Pumpkins are very fall-like, and of course, I mean, yeah. And more sunflowers, and you'll always find in my builds, I add plants. Lots of plants, maybe too many plants. This one's actually kind of toned down and a little proud of myself, but normally there's a lot of plants. And here's where I was struggling with not having CC, is I didn't have that many paintings that really kind of caught my eye for this. I liked that one. I did keep it for the hallway out there. And ultimately I couldn't find one, so I gave up for a little bit. I think I do end up putting a painting there though. And I get rid of the fish tank, pretty sure. Yeah, because I didn't want the fish tank to go in front of a wall or a window. And I just couldn't make it fit with the dining table. And yeah, again, struggling to find a rug. I need more plain brown rugs, more. I need all of the rugs. And here we're adding some fall decorations on the table, which I think really kind of brings out the fall colors with the curtains, and I liked that a lot. I guess there's not that many fall decorations. The idea is just that it was a comfy, casual home for your family Sims, and I'm sorry that it's not affordable. It's almost 100,000 simoleons, I think 97 or something like that. So, yeah, I guess, you know, it's a family home, you know. It's one of those family homes that you stay in forever, so it's your forever home, and yeah, I guess pretty standard. Here I'm adding some clutter to the laundry room because I found it while I was cluttering up the bathroom. And in taking out all of my CC, I took out my red shelf too, so I can't add stuff to the shelf. It's a struggle. I didn't really add much more to here. I added a workbench because it's a garage and maybe the husband likes to do some work or, I don't know. And I tried to add the fish tank upstairs too. I couldn't get it to work. I wanted to use those paintings. It wasn't happening. And I knew I wanted to add a desk up here because I didn't have one downstairs. And I think it's good to have a family computer, especially if you're actually playing in the house. It's pretty useful. So here is the rejected corner where nothing happens except a chair. And I just added some more lights, and yeah, that's pretty much it for the hallway. I got a fish bowl instead of a fish tank, and it, you know, did what it needed to do. I think I changed this layout though. Yeah, I do. And then again, issues with rugs. They're so hard to find one that you really, really want to fit. And I use this cute rug from Parenthood. I would have liked to use the whale swatch, but it wasn't really fitting the theme that we were going for. And here I'm doing the toddler's room. I was looking for a different bed, but I couldn't find it, so I ended up making a toddler, because originally it was a kid who loved animals. And I also added some more windows because I don't think you can actually define a bedroom as a bedroom if it's windowless, technically. I'm not sure if that's true. I could be telling lies. I don't know. But in any case, you want some light in your bedroom. I tried to fit a bookcase in, but it just was not working for me. And here I'm working on the kid's room. I imagine the kid was a bit, not older, but like older for her age. I thought that she would be kind of more mature. At first I was gonna go for like a cutesy girly theme or then a science theme with like the sunset, but then I found this color and I really liked it, so I went with it. And I think I do use that desk, that dresser. And I loved the bed swatch, but, you know, to make the furniture match, I had to make that kind of a white color, and I did not like it. I liked the cats and dogs dresser that had the brownish color that was really nice with the red, but I wanted to go with this bed, so I had to change it, unfortunately, but I like how it turned out. I think it was good. And we added, is that a dinosaur? I never know, is it a dragon or a dinosaur? But we end up adding the bunny and a little writing desk here. She doesn't have a computer, it's for her her diary. And we had some candles and a little bit of toys. I had the doctor kit at the ground, because then I thought maybe she doesn't want to be a scientist, maybe she wants to be a doctor. And yeah, I think it works. And I really liked the ladybug, but it didn't work for the room. And now we're on to the master bedroom, and I think it came together great. I mean, it ended up pretty big, I guess, because of this corner, but that's okay because we fill it out. And I really liked the red swatch of this bed. I wish I could have used the sunflower swatch, but the wood color was just too light and it just wasn't working. So, but we did get this yellow in the cats and dogs chair, so I thought that was quite nice. And just adding finishing touches there with some pictures and curtains, and Yeah, then we go downstairs back to the bathroom because I totally forgot to put a toilet roll, and there you see I changed the toilet roll because it was facing the wrong way. And just adding a little bit of leftover artwork, the last finishing touches. Do we add a chair in here? I think we do. Yeah, from City Living. I don't know what else from City Living's there, but if it's that just that chair, then you're probably good to download this without it. I really wanted to use that bench, but it just, again, not enough room. You know, if I would have made the porch a little bit bigger, but it was already pretty big, to be honest. And here I am working on the terrain. Honestly, it was a struggle. Because it was so close to the edge of the lot, I couldn't like smooth it more like I would have liked to. And but yeah, it turned out all right. I would have liked to have put a like car in it, but again, would have had the terrain issue. Here I'm adding a fence, and I changed it because I didn't like how it has the posts at different lengths, and that killed me inside a little bit. And I think I changed it a few times before settling on this color, but I'm not entirely sure. I added a pool back here. I know it's not very autumnal, but you know, because you're maybe not swimming in autumn unless you have like a heated pool. Maybe they do. I don't know. And but I thought it was very family fun. I know when I was a kid, I loved swimming. I still love swimming. It's good fun. And I just added some chairs and lounge chairs, as well as the drink tray from the backyard stuff, some planter boxes so your Sims can do some planting, a little wind chime. And I think that's it. I'm just gonna go into terrain editing now for terrain painting. Sorry, not editing. And I don't normally do that where I like fill out the area where I'm going to put stuff in, so to speak, but I guess it just worked that way this time. And I used these like hedges from Island Living, and I'm so grateful that they're so useful in other worlds. They're a nice pop of color, and I loved the orange, and I think it went really well with the orange flowers in the actual planter boxes, as well as like the more subdued tones of autumn. And when you see the screenshots, you'll see that it fades as well, but at the beginning of autumn, it's really, I don't think you can see that in the screenshots because I'm not in the beginning of autumn when I took those, but it, I don't know, it fits. I like it with the brown, and it's also very pretty. And here I'm adding some stones and putting flowers everywhere because why not? And I'm not gonna lie, I was struggling with the flower placements, but the problem with making the house go down is that it just, sometimes it still snaps for me, so it's a toss-up whether it's going to happen or not, and then I'm like, oh, well, it's not worth it. But we make it work. It works. I think it works. And adding some more flowers, I thought this looked really barren, so I just added some more, and I think that's pretty much it. I think we're coming up to the screenshots now, so I hope you liked the video, and if you did, let me know in the comments and show your support by tapping the like button and subscribe for more builds. Bye!